So let's start with the first technique, that is condition testing. So before we start, first we have to understand what is condition testing. So this is what we are going to address first. So have a look into this particular code where we are saying if A and B. So if this particular decision is correct, then execute statement 1. So this is the code. But when I am talking about condition, so first we have to focus on this particular decision. So as I have already said, if A and B is nothing but decision. So this as a whole called as decision. So what is condition then? So inside if you can see two things, one is A and B. So the complete decision depends upon these two conditions. So if the value of A is true or false, or if the value of B is true or false, depending upon that, the decision will be made. So here A and B as an individual called as atomic condition. So A as an individual called as atomic condition, and B as an individual called as an atomic condition. And together A and B are called as a conditions. And when they are in the form of if A and B, they are called as decisions. So now I hope you have understood what is the meaning of decision here and what is the meaning of condition here. And now when we talk about condition testing, then we have to test these conditions. That means for A as well as for B, we have to cover true condition as well as false condition. So one time A has to become true and the next time A has to become false. Similarly, one time B has to become true and next time B has to become false. To understand this concept, that is condition testing, we will go to the next lecture. So in this particular lecture, we will see what is condition testing. So now let's focus on the decision first. So this is what we had in the previous slide. If A and B. Now how we will perform a condition testing on it? So to perform condition testing, first we have to make this table. So here I have taken test 1 and test 2. Then I have taken A and B. So A is an atomic condition and B is also an atomic condition. After that, I have taken A and B as a whole. So this is a decision. So depending upon A and B, this particular decision will be changed. So now our focus is to cover condition testing for A and B. That means one time I have to make A as a false and next time I can make B as a true or false also. But now I have taken, because I can take only one value, so I have taken true here. You can take false also. So when I cover false and true, the final decision will be false. That means if A is false and B is true, then the whole result will be false because this is a AND condition. Similarly, now since I have covered false for A, now I have to cover true for A. So now you can see that for A we have covered false as well as true condition. Similarly, for B we have to cover true and false condition. So this way we can say that we have covered 100% condition coverage, because A is covered with false and true and B is also covered with true and false. But in the second test case also, the result will be false. That means if we try to cover condition testing, it is not necessary that we will cover decision testing. When I talk about decision testing, that means the complete decision also has to become true ones and false ones. But in our case, it has become only false. But we are not bothered about this part. In condition testing, we are only bothered about what is the value of A and B. So for value of A, we have to cover false and true. And for value of B, we have to cover true and false. And that is the reason we say this particular statement. 100% condition coverage does not cover 100% decision. So here we have covered 100% condition, but only 50% is decision, because only for decision we have covered only false, and true we have not covered. So this is a complete explanation of condition testing. So you have to understand this particular topic in order to answer the questions. That is it from this particular topic, and I will see you with the next topic. Until then, happy testing.